Oh, for a muse of fire that would ascend the brightest heaven of invention. A kingdom for a stage, princes to act, and monarchs to behold the swelling scene. Then should the warlike Harry, like himself, assume the port of Mars, and at his heels, leashed in like hounds, should famine, sword, and fire crouch for employment. But pardon, gentles all, the flat unraised spirit that hath dared on this unworthy scaffold to bring forth so great an object. Can this cockpit hold the vasty fields of France? Or may we cram within this wooden, oh, the very casks that did affright the air at Agincourt? Suppose within the girdle of these walls are now confined two mighty monarchies, whose high upreared and abutting fronts the perilous narrow ocean parts asunder. Piece out our imperfections with your thoughts. Into 1,000 parts divide one man, and make imaginary puissance. Think, when we talk of horses, that you see them printing their proud hooves at the receiving earth. For 'tis your thoughts that now must deck our kings. Carry them here and there, jumping o'er times, turning the accomplishment of many years into an hourglass. For the which apply, admit me chorus to this history, who prologue-like your humble patience pray, gently to hear, kindly to judge our play.
God save thy grace, King Hal, my royal Hal. God save thee, my sweet boy, my king, my Jove. I speak to thee, my heart. I know thee not, old man. Fall to thy prayers. How ill white hairs becomes a fool and jester. I have long dreamt of such a kind of man, so surfeit swelled, so old and so profane. But being awaked, I do despise my dream. Reply not to me with a fool-born jest. Presume not that I am the thing I was, for God doth know, so shall the world perceive, that I have turned away my former self, so will I those that kept me company. Falstaff, he is sick. The king hath killed his heart.
Well, Sir John is gone. God be with him. He parted even just between 12 and 1, e'en at the turn of the tide. Come, let's away. The king will be gone from Southampton. Let us to France, like horse leeches, my boys, to suck their very blood, to suck. Farewell, hostess. Touch her soft lips and part.
Now entertain conjecture of a time when creeping murmur and the pouring dark fills the wide vessel of the universe. From camp to camp through the foul womb of night, the hum of either army stilly sounds that the fixed sentinels almost receive the secret whispers of each other's watch. Proud of their numbers and secure in soul, the confident and over-lusty French do the low-rated English play at dice. The poor condemned English, like sacrifices, by their watchful fire sit patiently and inly ruminate the morning's danger. Oh, now who will behold the royal captain of this ruined band, walking from watch to watch, from tent to tent? Forth he goes and visits all his host, bids them good morrow with a modest smile, and calls them brothers, friends, and countrymen. Upon his royal face there is no note how dread an army hath enrounded him, nor doth he dedicate one jot of colour unto the wary and all-watched knight, but freshly looks and overbears attaint, with cheerful semblance and sweet majesty. That every wretch, pining and pale before, beholding him, plucks comfort from his looks. A largesse universal, like the sun, his liberal eye doth give to every one, thawing cold fear, that mean and gentle all behold, as may unworthiness define, a little touch of Harry in the night. This day is called the Feast of Crispian. He that outlives this day, and comes safe home, will stand a tiptoe when this day is named, and rouse him at the name of Crispian. He that shall live this day and see old age, will yearly on the vigil feast his neighbors and say, "Tomorrow is Saint Crispian." Then he will strip his sleeves and show his scars and say, "These wounds I had on Crispin's day." Old men forget, yet all shall be forgot, but he'll remember with advantages what feats he did that day. This story shall the good man teach his son, and Crispian shall ne'er go by from this day to the ending of the world, but we in it shall be remembered. We few, we happy few, we band of brothers. For he today that sheds his blood with me shall be my brother. Be he ne'er so vile, this day shall gentle his condition, and gentlemen in England now abed shall think themselves accursed they were not here, and hold their manhoods cheap, whiles any speaks that fought with us upon St. Crispin's Day. Awake remembrance of these valiant dead, and with your puissant arm renew their feet. You are their heir. You sit upon their throne. The blood and courage that renowned them runs in your veins. And my thrice puissant liege is in the very May morn of his youth, ripe for exploits and mighty enterprises. The day is ours, O God, thy arm was here. When without stratagem, but in plain shock and even play of battle, was ever known so great and little loss on one part and on the other? Take it, God, for it is none but thine. What is this castle called that stands hard by? They call it Agincourt. Then call we this the field of Agincourt, fought on the day of Crispin Crispianus. Do we now hold holy rites? Let there be sung Non Nobis and Te Deum. The dead with charity enclosed in clay, and then to Calais, and to England then, where ne'er from France arrived more happy men.